Alright, hey guys, this is Sarah's Night, and I'm back with Let's Play Bioshock 2. We'll be entering the third level now, called Pauper's Drop. You know, there was a whole lot of history behind this place that I just don't remember, because it's hard to process all the lore of Rapture, the Bioshock universe, at least all at once, to recall it, to even try to explain it to y'all, but... Yeah, Dr. Lab knows I'm coming this way, so now she's going to set everybody here against me. And basically she's saying, hey, it's honorable to gang up on me completely. I'm alone. Only Sinclair's help, but come on. Well, she is kind of a bitch. So, yeah, got a whole new story going on here at this point. All I can remember about this place is it's sort of like the low-income housing of Rapture. The ne'er-do-wells and all live in this area. And also the kind of the boss of this level, if you can call her that, is her name is Grace something. I don't remember her last name. I think Sinclair just mentioned it for me, but yeah, she's also got a personal vendetta against me because of an incident involving Eleanor a long time ago or something. Oh yeah, got a hack, duh. Of course, I don't even remember the hack button. What was it? I mean, I don't want to use my remote hacking darts here when this thing is right in front of me. There we go. Yeah, I'm playing this with a controller, but for some reason it's still telling me the keyboard control, so that's why I was confused there for a second. Okay, and this level, I just remembered, it takes a really long time, at least if I'm going to take this as slow as I'm intending to, trying not to game over. I mean, I know I already did once, but that doesn't mean I'm not going to, you know, continue to try to go with as few deaths as possible. So this is probably going to have to be separated out into two different videos. This takes a lot longer than the previous levels of the game. And let's just try to make this quick for these people. Oh, the others just left. Oh, actually I was about to say, did it turn out they were just gonna run from me anyway? So I basically just killed an innocent person in the back at first, but no, it looks like they were going to take a run at me anyway, even if I hadn't just did a back attack like that. I was like, that's not very honorable of me, even though I'm trying to take all the, make all the heroic choices in this playthrough by rescuing all the little sisters and stuff. Oh, hello. Oh, there's the Dr. Jekyll, Mr. Hyde splicer. That's a new form of splicer in this game that just got introduced. And oh, it's Grace. She knows I'm here. No, I think that was her mother, Dr. Lamb. It's hard to forget. It's black. Okay, that was wrong. I'm sorry. Yeah, Grace is basically misunderstood right now. She doesn't really understand. I mean, misguided. I think that's the word I was looking for. She really doesn't understand exactly who it is, whose side it is she's taking here. All she can remember is the propaganda that Dr. Lamb has given her about me, and the fact that, considering my bond with Eleanor, when she tried to pick up Eleanor once as a child, I, you know, took that as... like, I took that as a possible violent attack. I mean, because big daddies are programmed that way. If you get near a little sister, especially if you outright attack her, and I, like, broke her jaw with my drill or something. It's actually kind of a tough old lady for being able to take that and live. I mean, she can even talk just fine. It's not like it even did permanent damage to her face. But, of course, finding the way to Gracie to get the override key from her so I can continue on with my journey to Eleanor is going to, you know, be beset with obstacles. I can't just go straight there and do it, so we're going to be here for a while. You are not alone. Oh, and I think Grace's time here in Pauper's Drop, back in the day, she was like a bar singer or something and everybody liked her. I don't know. Yeah, and that's the first obstacle we gotta contend with. This Mr. Hyde Splicer right here just... drill fuel, free. So here's where the, just like in the first Bioshock, you know, the camera kinda came with an objective. You were supposed to intentionally look for it in order to help move the story along. So we gotta find a camera, and I think attack one of those brute splicers, what I call the Dr. Jekyll, Mr. Hyde guy, because that's just what he reminds me of. We gotta find one of those, take his picture to, and this is not good. Okay, I think we're just gonna try to run away here. Gotta go back this way anyway. Actually, I can hack one. I can hack this too. Good, because it belonged to that enemy splicer just now. Okay, the security bots got her for me. I'm just gonna leave that guy alone for right now, because I really do not have what it takes to fight him. I mean, those security drones come out when you F up a hack, and, well, that's kind of all my health, you know? But anyway, yeah, I gotta find the camera and use it on one of those brute splicers in order to get a particular offensive skill from. That will enable me to drill my way through all that wreckage. Have no Adam. Actually, now that I think about it, let's go back to that safe since I messed it up. I mean, right now I kind of need some equipment to help me out. Oh, don't worry, big guy. I have no intentions of messing with you right now. Got a remote hack dart and a rivet from that. Honestly, an auto hack dart would have been a little more useful right now. Okay, that's back the way towards the train. I heard a maniacal splicer laughing. Here's a carcass of a Rosie, Big Daddy. Okay, yeah, I think the safe is back this way. And let's see what we can get out of there. Got a couple of auto-hack darts, so I don't mind using one of them on this thing. Okay, that's nice. But yeah, oh, those brute splicers, they suck. I really hate fighting them. If you manage to kind of stun one, though, just like with any other splicer, if he's by himself, it kind of gives you the opportunity to just get up in his face and drill him to death. And while I'm at it, let's go ahead and take care of the security camera over here. Oh! I didn't think he could... Okay, I don't know what this Rosie Big Daddy is doing right here. He's not with the little sister, it looks like. Okay, seriously, what is this guy doing? In any event, let's, yeah, there we go. That'll help me against any attacks that happen in here. Oh, there's a little sister. I was wondering. I wonder if the Big Daddy just... I don't know if he kind of glitched out and he just started wandering away. Okay, let's follow the arrow now. Screw this. Chill out, buddy. Ah, here we are. All right, what you got? Uh-oh. Okay, here we go. I can kinda... It's gonna take up most of my drill fuel, but it's cool. Oh, no, you don't. Oh, that's what he was going for. He was opening up the way for other splicers to attack me. Oh, what, seriously? Yeah, dude's got a lot of his HP. Got a lot of HP on him. You know, I wonder, since he opened the way in here, that was meant to imply that the splicers can actually use the Vita Chambers too, or at least they're smart enough to know to use them. And maybe one that I killed earlier in this area actually got dragged over by a friend and revitalized in there. And that was the person who came out when the brute slicer pushed a hole in that wall.
Well, there's the pawn shop, but it's bolted up tight.
Yep. Just like with most levels in Bioshock, I mean, either game, you got one objective just to make it through the level, and then immediately stuff starts getting in the way of that first objective and kind of keeps piling on, you know? I mean, I can't even get into the place where the camera is now. I gotta find another way in. What have we got here?
Job to pick up a new key code to keep them out. Seems like I'm in a day now. Nuts.
That key code being what? I didn't hear you mention it. You know? I've got the hill station right here. Anti-personnel rounds. I don't know if that... I actually do not know if that includes Big Daddy enemies or just normal splicers. Well, I got quite a few trap rivets here. That is a Rosie, however, so he can keep attacking me from far away without tripping over the trap rivets. Eh, you know what, to hell with it. Okay, let's listen to that audio diary again, see if I can... No, not that one, sir. Oh, it was telling me the new code was in the diner. Okay. Well, at least Sinclair kind of seems to empathize with the poor. He's like, well, it does suck to be them. Okay, code in the diner here. And you know what? I'm willing to bet that splicers are going to come out as soon as I discover it in here. Let's be careful. Zero, zero, four, seven. I wonder if I can actually know. Can't squeeze through there. Baby snatcher. Grace, you really don't get it, do you? Whoop. My bad.
Grace, he's got the wrong idea. You're not responsible for turning Eleanor into a little sister. Big daddies are just slaves. And you...
Exactly. How could I be? And being a citizen of Rapture, Grace should actually... know enough about how it works. Oh, camera. Ah, crap. Well, you know, if there's a hill station here, hack everyone you can find. Just cost me $9 to have to duck that flaming barrel the splicer put down the stairs for me. Okay, let's hack this thing. Yeah, and one of Grace's announcements over the PA system, talking about how she was gonna hang me from a treetop or something, or the roof of a building. Can you even strangle a big daddy to death? Can you even wrap your arms, much less be strong enough, around a big daddy's throat? Okay, let's see if we can get their attention and then light the. Oh! There we go. I do not know who that was, though. That was. Whoa! Can actually reach up on this thing. There we go. What's she talking about? Let's go back to the hill station. It's so weird to think that, I mean, even without the use of a med kit and one life, even if this is hard mode, that a thuggish slicer with just three or four swings of a wrench can actually kill a big daddy. Never even went this way. That's cool. If you, apparently, if you hit the blue section twice, you can get two items out of here. And there's a weapon station, too. Fuel efficiency. That sounds good. My bad.
Another day, no clients. Atlas and Ryan start going at it hot and heavy, and all my business dries up. Used to be easy. Put the eye on some spliced up dame's wandering husband and raking the dough. Now it's got so bad I had to put my camera in Hawking King Vaughn. Makes a guy consider splicing up himself.
So apparently it's this Flanagan guy's camera we're looking for, I suppose. Speaking of which, use the term spliced up dame. Honestly, once you get that Adam addiction and become a splicer, I mean, come on, you've seen the women splicers' faces. Can you really call them dames anymore? Alright, down here. There it is. Okay, I believe this is likely where splicers are going to attack. I just remembered it occurring from outside the windows of some diner or something I was in. Let's set up some trap rivets. Well, actually, I mean, if they can even get in here. Or maybe they just stay shooting from outside the windows the whole time. In that case, I mean, trap rivets would be worthless. They'll never walk in here. We should, however, take anti-personnel rounds.
That thing's a miracle in Technicolor, kid. Works like a movie camera. Start the film rolling before you open fire on a splicer, and then anything you hit it with tells you more about his DNA. Let's give it a dry run, shall we?
Yeah, but then again, there's no getting out of here. For myself. So, yeah, trap rivets. Somebody's gotta come in here somehow. Ooh. I didn't know a big day could actually... A little too much alcohol there, SK. Okay, am I an idiot? How do you get out of here? There he goes.
Then hit him with a little bit. That's it, son. Camera spits out a prize once in a while as you learn what makes a splicer tick. Now, find one of those big old brutes and take him out on film. Before long, you'll be able to brush aside that mess at the hotel.
Indeed. Okay, so the camera does work differently. Uh-oh. Somebody coming out to greet me here? Yeah, the camera works differently in this game than before. All you had to do was keep taking pictures of enemies. And of course, eventually, you know, if you kept using it on the same enemy, the score would go down. But here, you kind of gotta try different things with them while the camera, like, while the film reel is going. And depending on... I don't know, like, how much variety or creativity you used in your attack. That will, you know, that will give you so many points towards learning a new passive or aggressive skill off of them. I mean, it's a little bit annoying because it just kind of adds an extra burden on trying to decide on what to use on the next, you know, the next time on the same enemy when you're just trying to learn all the abilities off of them. But, you know... It was kind of a nifty idea, I guess.
Using that camera's a bit like telling a joke. Each time you tell it the same way.
Yeah, see, Sinclair explains it here.
So you gotta change it up to keep it fresh.
And here, I kind of wonder if I just take a picture of the Big Daddy. Yeah, the other splicer's attacking it right here. I think. Actually kind of gives me points, so I don't even have to upset the Big Daddy. I'm just kind of getting it for free here. That also took a good deal of his HP off, so you know what? Die! There we go. Oh. Sorry, I just switched to whatever weapon I could find next so I wouldn't die. And immediately, as soon as another Big Daddy steps in his place, she's like, all happy again. Okay, we need to heal up, seriously. That'll do for now. Okay, so let's shift our attention from our main goal at the moment. Trying to find a brute splicer and taking a picture of him to gain some more addendum using the little sister. Alright, and here's a corpse right here. Oh, that's kind of nice. We had this camera right here that we just hacked to kind of assist in the fight. Very convenient. So then... Oh! Whoa! What the... Okay, somebody just jacked me up pretty good, I ain't gonna lie. Oh, I remember now. I believe there is a rocket turret over there. And that got me absolutely no... Oh, because I took a picture of the wrong thing. Whoops. The good news is, it doesn't take any film to use the camera. You don't have to keep searching for ammo for that. Now then, let's see if we can hack that friggin' turret over there. Auto hack dart. I believe he's right here. Whoa! And that's done. Okay, well, now I am really reserved about starting a fight over here with a big daddy in range. It's kind of weird how the little sister doesn't make any remark on this either. Okay, he's going for another little sister, but... Ah, man.
Remember, son, without using that research camera, we can't get to Gracie, and that means we're stuck here.
Okay.
Those big apes on film, then work him over.
I get it, Sinclair, but right now I kind of got to worry about something else. I'm sorry, guys. Just let me wait for them to kind of get out of here. I'll explore the surrounding area for a little bit. Because I know that in the middle of that fight, it will be impossible for me to be able to keep an eye on him, and I'll end up hitting him with one of my weapons by accident. And then I'll really be screwed. Oh! Hi! Oh my gosh, that... You know, I know the little sister doesn't really know what she's saying, but that is kind of sick. Oh, well, this is nice. Here's another one. Oh, that actually does come into play soon.
Welcome, they says. They got big promises. Salvation, immortality, a way out of here.
All through Eleanor somehow.
Crazy it sounds. A way out of Rapture's music to my ears. Next Sunday morning, I'll be there.
Oh, sorry, you poor deleted bastard. Okay, I hear the big daddy tromping around, so I really do not... Let me just make sure he's not really anywhere close by. Oh, cool. Tonic. That will be nice to have. Anybody who touches me, they get set on fire. Yeah, there's a big daddy right here. Oh. You just had to come this way. Just kind of move. All right, chill, buddy. Okay, at least I can come down here and do my thing now. Wait, was that a corpse swimming by? Oh. No, it's a big sister. I guess she's just swimming around, just waiting for the time when she'll make her entrance in this level when I rescue all the little sisters. Okay. Set up my usual perimeter here and try to keep an eye on the pond over here so whenever a splicer is dumb enough to walk through it, I can get some extra damage in. Alright, go for it. I really do not understand why Grace is acting like she's controlling the good guys here. They're splicers. They accost little sisters far more than I do. Somebody sees me. Oh. Bye. Okay, Big Daddy, please do not touch me. Oh. Okay, he was fighting some other splicers. Yeah, so it really doesn't matter, even if I get a back cut on trying to film an enemy because, well, I mean, I can use it as many times as I want. Don't have to worry about ammo. So before we get into that next Adam fight, let's just get a couple med kits. Unfortunately, I think the Big Daddy went back this way. Crap. Ugh. You're not gonna get out of my way either, are you? By the way, can you... Oh, no. Little sisters don't give you any abilities, so... What? What is she doing? She's just kind of being a brat right now, I guess. She also kind of glitched out. Can't get where, huh? What? Oh. Okay, good. Now she's following him. Yes, please, walk on. I would really like for you to get out of my way. Don't touch that corpse either. Alright, let's just kind of at least wait for them to disappear around the corner. Keep going, thank you. Oh, on second thought, maybe I shouldn't set up any traps. Well, from this direction I will. Oh, whoops. Hit that enemy instead. Even though it was dead, it still counts as... Okay, well, I can at least do it from this angle, but I'm worried about doing it over here in case the Big Daddy comes back. Aggravated by the splicers that will attack me or something and hits the trap rivet first, then he'll take that as an affront for me. You know, like you've already tried to show me several times before already in this level, and probably will many more times before the end of this. Well, I really don't want to have to look down that hall because any enemies that come from this side. They're playing 20th century blues right now. Alright, that's the end of that. I'm also curious, the music started at some point during the fight. Who turned it on? Why is it off now? Oh, there it goes again. Oh, it's this record player. Or is this a record player or a jukebox? I don't know. I was wondering if you could actually get any points whatsoever researching a dead body. Okay, so let's just find, let's find this little sister hidey hole over here and... kind of wondering how it is she even really knows that she was in some kind of weird demonic state beforehand so that she actually thanks me. But it looks like she was totally self-aware the whole time somehow. Get one more. And let's just stop by a gatherer's garden, upgrade my health, and Eve, and we'll be ready to kind of continue on here. Oh. And somehow I keep crouching by accident in the middle of backing up from a splicer. I don't know how. What the? What's with all these enemies coming out of the woodwork? Oh, and this place is boarded up. Sinclair Deluxe Hotel, I guess. That was a way in. Dr. Lamb can help you plan for the future. Wow, there was absolutely nothing over here. Except more enemies. That did not help me at all. There's the brute splicer. Alright, let's hack this one with a dart. And I missed. And this thing can die. Oh, well, you'll die over there anyway.
Look at you, sport. A regular junior shutterbug. And it appears you've picked up a new trick from that big galoot. Now get back to the Sinclair Deluxe and just bust through that mess blocking your way.
No problem, but I would like to find a gatherer's garden first. Now, it does take some drill fuel to do this new ability, Dash. So I don't think I can do it right now, but... Wow. That's almost like saying a poor person is evil for their miserable state. What, you're homeless? Hey, you must be an asshole. I mean, it's like she's trying to convince everybody I'm evil just because I have no family of my own. Anyway, Gatherer's Garden is right here. Good. Let's get to that health and ETH upgrade and, what else we got here? Oh, Booze Hound. Definitely enjoy that. But let's make sure there's nothing else I'll want. Because we only have enough to get one more gene tonic slot in order to accommodate that Booze Hound tonic. Totally worth it, though. So now I don't have to worry about a trade-off whenever I drink alcohol. I'll get some Eve, too, along with it instead of it decreasing. And holy crap, is there another Brute Splicer? There is! Can't just keep fighting those guys, you know. Well, if I'm gonna try to take it on, I'm gonna need some more health for sure. And I have no money left. That sucks. Well, actually, if I could just... Excuse me. Yeah, I just don't have any ammunition right now. I'm just gonna sneak around you here, buddy. If I could refill my drill fuel one more time at that, in fact, it's right up here. It's in the direction I meant to go anyway. I don't disagree with you on that. Against him in song, and he had her blacklisted. It left her penniless. But in the family, she has found hope, a reason to draw breath.
Ask yourself, Delta, do you deserve to take it from her? Nobody's trying to. I just want Eleanor back.
Just rev up that drill of yours and slam right through that pile of junk blocking your way.
Already did, thank you. don't know if you can use this any more times. I thought it was only two or three. But we'll try it again if I run out. Okay, now to make our way to Grace, or at least work on it. So yeah, the drill dash is also really useful. If you electrocute a splicer, and you can just kind of like close the distance if you were far away in an instant, you'll generally get her with one swipe upside the head. Whoa! Now that I think about it, I think it was just a matter of getting up to the top from here with really no more, you know, at least huge obstacles in the way. Yeah, see, just like that. That's a good one-hit kill for economizing on fuel, too. So now that I think about it, let's not continue up this way for now. Because there were a lot more side places to explore down below. We'll work on that next time. Or I mean, continuing with the main objective. In fact, if I'm lucky, I can kind of take on a big daddy right now with all this drill fuel. I see this typewriter and I'm inclined to interact with it, hoping to save like it was Resident Evil. Guys, I got to say, in terms of just what's been going on with me personally lately, just finally getting back on with the move to the immigration to Canada. I tell you, I mean, I've been sitting here kind of sitting on my hands in Houston for a while since I lost my job in Shreveport, and that's when I kind of felt the calling from God to move north. And no, I promise it's not because Trump's becoming president. I was thinking about this long before I even knew the guy was running. I'm not thrilled about it, but, you know. So I finally kind of got back on with that objective, and it was a matter of just, at first I finally just decided to get the help of some lawyers, like immigration lawyers, to kind of help me determine what to do next, and then it's like, you know, I gotta take this, one of the first things they suggested I do was actually just... Wow. Huh. I just want to say right quick, it's kind of amazing that I managed to kill this guy completely in... Whoa. Where do you think you're going, asshole? Well, let's pick her up. Yeah, they suggested one of the first things to do was to actually take this English language proficiency test, which I kind of knew about already when I was trying to investigate the subject on my own in the few days, the few weeks I had before leaving Shreveport completely for Houston, just to try to find work here in the meantime while I was in the process of moving. But yeah, even though I know English, I mean, that's my only language actually, it was like... you know, you have to prove to the Canadian Immigration Service that you do know it. At least through a matter of... Whoops. I didn't realize. I pressed the wrong button when trying to heal. My bad. And the little sister's just, like, right here. Anyway, so it's actually like this, it's like taking one of those friggin' standardized tests in elementary school. Yeah, and it takes forever to get through. Okay, yeah, can I still use it? I don't know, it starts to look more beat up, it seems, every time I use it. I don't know if it has infinite uses. So I was, you know, I finally applied for that. It costs like over $200, and yesterday I'm waking up, even though I work at night, so I'm used to waking up at noon in order to go to work and kind of staying up late into the morning, or late into the night, I guess, which is early hours of the morning, 2, 3 in the morning. You know, I gotta wake up at like 6:30, and I'm spending pretty much all day at this test, at this language testing center downtown, and I'm the only idiot there, you know, who's like white. Everybody else, you know, they're like Muslims or blacks or something, and I guess they're, you know, they actually are just, they just now came here from another country maybe, and are trying to learn, you know, trying to prove that they know English and all that kind of stuff, because it probably wasn't their first language coming from overseas. So, I mean, I don't know, I kind of felt they were all like looking at me, you know, as we're all gathering together to be identified using our passports and all this other junk. They were really tight on security around there. It was awkward. But, I don't know, I kind of felt their eyes just all upon me there, you know, like, why is this guy who speaks perfect English and is clearly an American-born Caucasian, what is he doing there? What is he doing here? And somebody, you know, like this Russian lady finally asked me straight up why, while I'm taking the test, I'm like, well, for some reason, Canadian Immigration Service, they require you to take this IELTS test. That's what it's called. IELTS. I don't know what it stands for. They require you to take it, you know, before you can even apply for immigration. And she's like, really? You're wanting to move to Canada? Surely it's not just because of Donald Trump. I was like, nah. Oh, so this is an interesting audio diary on this public debate between Sophia and Ryan. And both of them raise good points. Yeah, Sophia's like, you know, in a way, your philosophies, however man-centered, are kind of religious in themselves. Oh no, I just thought it was interesting. Okay, so, let's go ahead and get this Adam gathering fight out of the way. I'll go ahead and use some anti-personnel rounds starting out. Alright, enjoy. Yeah, I mean, like, the last part of the test, after, you know, taking literally 6 hours into the morning, like, up until noon, a little bit past it, actually, taking all the other parts of the test, you know, I'm required to, like, come back after so long, and then I have to just, like, answer questions, like, in English, I guess, to demonstrate how well I can speak it, actually, not just read and write. In front of, like, this one person, I was worried it was going to be, like, an entire panel of judges or something, and it'd be really weird and embarrassing, but... She asked me to talk about the weirdest shit, too, like... Okay, I think I'm out of health here. And I might die. Aha! That was close. But she's all done. Yeah, she was, the person I had to, like, spend 15 minutes just talking in front of, she asked me all these questions. At first, it was just about, like, personal, personal life, like, real small talk stuff, like, okay, first, pronounce your name, where are you originally from, what's your date of birth, all this other crap. But then, just after the first couple of minutes asking questions like that, the rest of the time, for about another 10 minutes, it was all about asking me my views on, like, the upbringing of children in modern society. I guess in particular America, it's like, do you feel that children should have a lot, be given a lot of toys when they're young? Do you think the modern technological age with all the cell phones and all that and tablets and all that kind of stuff, do you think it's like beneficial to children or it's damaging to their social adaptability? Like all this other stuff. It's just concerning like how to raise children right, and I'm just like, I don't know. But I mean, I guess I managed to bullshit my way through it well enough. I don't know if you're really supposed to be able to debate this or anything or give a solid opinion. It's just, okay, how well can you just speak English and answer the question? But yeah, so that's how I spent most of my weekend. I mean, just pretty much all day yesterday. Okay, there needs to be at least one more Adam Gathering fight to do here. Speaking of which, is that the last little sister in this level? Okay, I think the face of a little sister means I'm actually, that's the one that I'm carrying on my back right now, so it is telling me, since there's another picture of a, since there's another picture of a little sister next to her, next to a big daddy, that means that I'm going to find at least one more big daddy escorting little sister in this level, and I have to rescue her. And unfortunately, this one is right in the middle of every place, and I have no money to buy extra ammunition. I really do not want to do this right now. With the meager weapons that I have. I mean, I guess I can just try drill dashing everybody. Really need to keep the first aid going. You know, for now, let's just try to explore some side areas we have not been to yet at all. We'll see if we can gather up enough stuff to... Wait, have I been here already? Yeah, this was the dead end leading to a boarded up Sinclair Deluxe, wasn't it? Let me just make sure one more time if this was an absolute dead end or not. Nothing, just I guess this is a hidey hole for her little sister. You know, let's just go ahead and send her on her way. Oh, I was wrong. Here is a big sister. So, the portrait of the little sister by itself, that was one I had already rescued, and the one with the big daddy, that might have been indicating that I either need to still rescue her from one, or I am carrying her with me right now. In any event, I just hadn't actually, you know, brought her to a hiding place and completely freed her yet. Oh, crap. Oh, she's in the room with me. I can tell. Well, I'm probably gonna die a few times here. Let's drill into her. Oh. (laughs) She's already back out here, isn't she? We'll just stay next to... What? Oh, good. The Splicer's attacking that Big Daddy over there, so I guess I don't have to worry right now. Okay, listen, Chick, if you're here, just come on. Bring it on. Let's get this over with. Don't just try to intimidate me from somewhere in the room where I can't even see you. Don't hit me! I was going for the health station. Okay, I'll admit, at this point, I'm not really trying to avoid Das. Just to get rid of her. Oh, you know, I can get some stuff from Gatherer's Garden here. Let's see if anything can help. I'll definitely need another gene tonic slot. I guess armored shell. I mean, that's always good to have. Careful hacker, hacking needle moves slightly slower. Pretty sure I can get that for free soon. Headshots do more damage, that's nice, but a little bit expensive for my taste right now. We'll just keep an empty plasmid slot for now. Might as well go ahead and get another one of these. Got a trap rivet. Are you here? Oh, they can. Wow, I did not notice that. I just noticed that. Whoa. Yeah, I'm so freaking dead. I really kind of put myself in a bad situation here. I'm sorry, I know this is full of fail right now. Say, okay, I can't get in here. Just by going through the door like a normal person instead of trying to actually... SK, this is embarrassing, buddy. You were not prepared for this at all. And these splicers just keep randomly appearing. You know, now that I think about it, let's see if we can make our way over here to that drill fuel station. Maybe it still has another use, I don't know. Well, Looks like I can still use it. Well, that's that. You know, I would assume since I've been able to use it like 5 or 6 times so far that this is completely infinite. I was worried about, you know, just using it whenever I walked by it in the past though, because I thought it only had a limited amount. So I wanted to wait until I was completely empty. Would have done myself a world of good if I'd... Okay, let's just... kinda... Did I get any atom off of that? Yeah, I did. So, I kinda like the idea of drill lurker. Of course, I don't really focus on using stealth when trying to fight in this game. Like sneaking up behind them, we'll just screw that one. Electrical attacks, disable security devices much longer, heh. I'll just go ahead with careful hacker, I guess. Hopefully it's not something I was gonna pick up in this level or later on. Shotgun buck. Don't have a shotgun yet, unfortunately. Ah, there we go. Hill station. Okay, so. Before we move on with the main objective, I'm going to go back by... I think we've pretty much done everything here. Yeah, I do know of one passage that I have not completely explored yet. And let's go ahead and make sure we've covered everything there before continuing on into the broken down apartment building where Grace is waiting for me. Let's also check out up here. Whoa! No wonder I got machine gunned in the back when I was trying to fight that brute splicer. I did not notice you, buddy. Okay, well. Nothing interesting up here, it looks like. That was, is this back towards the apartment building, or... Okay, that goes back to the... That goes back to the train. Over on the opposite side is where I had to unlock the way to the camera, so let's continue on this way. That place is boarded up. Yeah, meant to go this way anyway. Okay, next time, I'm going to put up a much better fight. Because I'm going to make sure I'm prepared first before I free all the little sisters in the level. Now, problem is, this is not the way I meant to go. Okay, this is leading just to the apartment building. I'm trying to find the way back to that... Back to that passage where... Kind of feel sorry for the big daddy who has no little sisters to find and take care of in this level now. Kind of sucks to be him. Huh, what's this? Ah, this is where I was looking for.
The tin daddy is not a man. It is half dog and half devil, made by Andrew Ryan to condemn our children to a walking death.
Are you still pissed because I'm alive despite all of your attempts to kill me so far? The big sister doesn't count. That was not sent by you. Okay, yeah, I meant to continue on down this way. This is what I was looking for.
There's one of those big goons now. Start your camera rolling on him, and then let him have it.
Yeah, and I think Sinclair is still referring back to my previous objective of finding a brute splicer and gaining his ability with the camera, but of course I already did that. It's just I could have continued on down this way and gotten this guy instead. Well, let's start with the camera. Yeah, with your drill, with all the little weapon upgrades that come along with it, drill is generally your best. Ah, missed. What? Okay, where did all these guys come from? Say, is there like a, Okay, heal. There we go. Whew. Oh, the hypnotized plasmid. That's cool.
Hypnotize your foes. Laugh as they fight each other.
Yeah, they kind of renamed it from the previous game. I think it was called Enrage at that point. And they also had another, Bioshock 1 also had another plasmid called Hypnotize, but it had a different purpose. It was for hypnotizing a big day into fighting for you. Okay, guys, I really don't want to do this, but I know you're going to attack me if I just try to walk by you. You know, they could have genuinely been lovers or something, and they were just dancing, pretty innocent. Kind of feel bad for this. Because I had manipulated them into killing each other. Yeah, not much use out of that piano. Yeah, so I think where we are at right now, this was, what's this called again? The Limbo Room? This is where Grace used to sing when she was younger and prettier. Yeah, and everybody loved her, and now she's a bitter old woman. Oh, good. Weapon upgrade. So I can deflect. I forgot about this one. I can... actually, not deflect, but reflect incoming projectiles if my drill just happens to be spinning. I don't know if I really got the cat-like reflexes for that, though, you know? To make use out of that. For right now, let's just go with machine gun damage. Let's just say, we will be reborn. This might have even been Grace's dressing room. Yep. Just trying to follow the arrow, and all I'm doing is turning myself around. Anything over in this corner? No. Two payphones for whatever reason. With the old rotary dial, but it, of course this is the 50s, so I guess that only makes sense. Well, let's just go ahead and make sure while I explore this thing isn't going to be in my way. Looks like there's more. Whoops. Of course, arrows are also pointing back this way, so I guess it really doesn't make a difference. It's probably just going to circle around somehow. Don't recall being in here, though. Oh, okay. I see where we're at now. But let's make sure I covered everything. I don't think it was either one, really. Okay, guys. At this point, we can just... wait. Why are you pointing this way? This is that dead end again, isn't it? Or so I thought. Odd. Well, anyway, like I said, now we only have one objective left, and that's to storm the apartment building where Grace Holloway is waiting for me so I can get the friggin' key from her. And anyway, I think we can save that for next time.